Good morning, folks. How are you today? It's pretty early outside. I was up really early this morning, trying to take care of a few things, and as you can see, I'm handling some business. I'm out and about and trying to get some stuff done. And many of you are just waking up. Some of you have already had your morning coffee and you're about to get started on your day, about to go to work or caretake your children or whatever you're doing. But I wanted to take a few moments to talk to you folks about something that I really think is important for you to try to grab, to get a better understanding of yourselves when you're in a place of lowness. And I talk a lot to people about always having to deal with other people who are giving you negative energy in your space and eliminating the negative energies and stuff like that. And I'm always speaking about that because, see, these things are important because when you really get into violence and certain things, they all emanate from a place of misunderstanding and miscommunication and stuff like that. And it's important for people to try to understand each other. You know, if you're one of these dysfunctional people, then that is one of the D's that I want to talk to you about today. Actually, this lecture is going to be about the three D's, right? And these three D's are relative to your behavior in a bigger context, right? And they're disturbed, displaced, and dysfunctional. And those are the three things that people are, and they're all interconnected because, see, when you're disturbed, you're not in your right place of mind. And so then you become displaced, right? And then you live dysfunctionally. So all three of those things are actually connected to each other. And those three D's, if you can eliminate one of them, you can eliminate the other two. And then you can have a better peace of mind and a better understanding of yourself, which will in turn result in others understanding you better. All right, so let's start with the first D. And we're going to say that is disturbed, which is what I just said to you. To be disturbed is to not be in a sound place in your mind, right? You may rationalize, and I can give you some examples to show you disturbia. Most of you folks know what disturbia is and have an understanding of what that is. Some of these attacks on people and some of these outward things and murders and stuff like that, those people are clearly not sound. And so they're not in the right framing of mind to understand that they're humans, and to violate another human is in turn actually violating yourselves on some level, right? So you're disturbed. So we can just push that one out because I understand that a lot of you understand what disturbed is in the context of it being presented to you from another source, right? But you many of you don't understand that you yourselves are disturbed, right? And when you do things, when you come from a place in your mind that is not sound, anything else that you do is not going to be sound, right? Because you're not even thinking on decent terms as far as how you want to conduct yourself. You're not even aware of how to conduct yourself, right? And there are many reasons why this could be. It could be, like I said, I'm one of these strong proponents of understanding how, when you develop, how the people who are around you, who sculpted and molded you and your upbringing, those are the people who really assist you. I mean, they can't completely assist you because some people are just born deformed in their mind, but they can assist you on some level where they can help you be more healthy from being a baby on up to an adult, and they can help guide you in a way that keeps you from being as disturbed as you possibly could be. All right, so let's talk about displacement. When you're disturbed, you become displaced, meaning that your place relative to other people in the world and your place in the world, you don't know where you are. You don't know who you are, right? Because you're not in the right framing of your mind, like I said, it's all connected, right? So you become displaced in many ways. You may have a job, okay, and you're not behaving properly on your job because you have some issues. You're disturbed, like I was just saying. And because you're disturbed, you do not know how to function in a work environment, and you become displaced, right? So what happens when you become displaced? You know, you may lose your job. You may get suspended. You may have an altercation on your job because you're not able to work in a sound environment because, once again, you're disturbed. You started this off in a bad place, right? And you're not going to end up in a better place because you started this whole thing off with dysfunctional, from a dysfunctional place, excuse me. So you know, you're displaced. And, you know, in many ways, that plays out in many ways. I mean, it could be in the form of, you know, you could be a young adult. You could be living with your parents and, you know, I'm sorry, with your parents. And you can have a situation where you're not listening to them, or you're not, you know, you're not being cooperative. And then they wind up, what do? You know, most of you folks have been through this. Some of you have, at least, kicked out of your house, out of your homes. Right. And then you find yourself displaced from your sound home environment. And then you're out in the street, and then you because you're disturbed, like I said, you do things, you resort to doing things for your, on the lowest level of survival, because it's about survival then. Right. So, you know, displacement happens in many forms, and it's connected to that first thing I was talking to you folks about being disturbed, because really being disturbed sets the course for everything else. If you're not right in your mind, the other two D's will follow, right? And that was displacement, and then the other one was being dysfunctional, right? So you have the three D's: disturb, displace, and dysfunction. And let's get into dysfunction. When we talk about dysfunctional, you are completely at this point messed up. Everything you do gives you a poor result, right? You can't work a job. You can't get along with others. You know, you're not able to manage your time. You're not able to set goals for yourself. And you're just completely dysfunctional, right? And you operate from a place of chaos in your day-to-day. And many of the people around you may operate from that same place, right? And those three D's, you know, if you can set your course without having to experience those three D's at all, then you'll be better off, right? And you won't have to really, you know, struggle with these things. But see, you know, and it's important, because here's why I'm talking to you folks. You know, the important thing here is to grab that you're going to live in a world full of people. It's never going to stop, you know. And you're gonna always have people around you who are not healthy mentally. I mean, that's just a giver. And the way I look at this in most cases is that most people, you know, like I told you, I have studied this, folks. I have really put my time and homework and effort into this, and I really understand people, right? I look at people every day. Now, I go into situations, and I always make it a point to not try to go into a situation from a bad place. You know, when I encounter other people, you know, most of the time I try to avoid negative people because I can sense negative people and I stay away from them. But when I have to deal with these people, right, I'm very limited in how I interact, right? It's only about something I'm trying to accomplish, and then I go on. And you folks may, you know, you on your jobs or something, you probably can develop this technique, and it'll keep some of your sanity. Not all of it, because you're still going to have very stressful days, but it's going to help you a little bit, okay? I see too many folks, and I always say this. Y'all hear me say too many, so many. Y'all always hear me say these minis, because there are a lot of people, right, who are really mentally disturbed in this world, right? And not just, I mean, just think about it. Just think about this for a minute. Where you live, in your hometowns, in your communities, right? In the state that you live in. If some of you live in other parts of the world, in the provinces and stuff that you live in, right? You know, these, you know how many people, you always have to go confide in a friend, or you always have to talk about your bad day. And it's always like that, because there's always someone else looking to create havoc. I mean, looking to create some kind of dysfunction that you'll have to deal with in your day. Now, the people are doing it because it's a mechanism in their minds that they need for their peace of mind. You know, some people need to operate in that dysfunction I was talking to you about. And that is wholly not necessary, right? We can live our lives as humans and we should be able to all get along, right? And people who don't believe, like I always say, people who don't believe that this is possible are themselves the problem. Because if many of you folks out there, if you want it to be better, you could at least make an effort, right? Sometimes you can be beat down so much in life and you could have had so many bad experiences that it takes a lot to get uphill to become better people. But you can do it. And all it takes really is for you to look into yourselves and try to believe that you are a better person, that you're, and just try to make an effort. Because I keep saying this, you know, I deal with so many people for various reasons. I do a lot of business. I'm always moving and shaking and I'm always doing something. And I always have to deal with other people. And I'm aware of the fact that this is the world that I'm living in, and that if I want to get ahead, I'm going to have to function in these capacities. And so I do my best, you know, but there're just so many folks, you know, there're just so many folks that are just not mentally right. You know, so many people that are just not in a healthy place. And I don't know. I really don't have answers. You know, I can speculate why you're dysfunctional, you know. And like I said, you know, dysfunction begats dysfunction. So your parents, if they were not solid people, and in some cases you didn't have both of your parents. Sometimes you had one, but it doesn't matter. That person who raised you, if they were not mentally right, then what could they give you, right? And I'm just coming from a technical, scientific standpoint, from social science standpoint. You know, if they were not right, how in the world could you expect to even have a fighting chance if they can't show you love? Now, the reason why I want to talk about this is because, you know, the other day I was visiting some folks. And, you know, they have a son, a young son, and he's not a young, like a kid, but this guy is about maybe in his early 20s. And these people are, you know, at best, they're really low level people, right? Because they don't have, I can't say any really thing good about them other than, you know, they get along in life and they handle their business as far as that. But as far as being people, they really suck as people. And the mother of this particular young man, it was a very hard-nosed lady. You know, she's the type of person that she doesn't have any sympathy. You know, she's not really an empathetic person. So, you know, they never got nurturement from this woman, right? And this child, you know, he's the type of person where, you know, you say, hey, man, how you doing? And he's just really quiet, right? And he doesn't know how to connect with other people. But then when I look at his parents, I look at how they connect to each other, and then I look at how they connect to him. And, you know, I'm sure when he, you know, some of these times in his life when he really needed a support network or someone to talk to, I'm sure it was not available to him. And so now as a present day adult, he's struggling in his social relationships, and he doesn't, and you know, and maybe he doesn't even think about this. Maybe he doesn't realize how he's projected, but he's a very aloof person, but not aloof because people are bad, because he himself is a very dysfunctional person. I just think that he could have been given more of a chance to be shown some love, right, when he was younger. And I see this, you know, I'm not in a place now where I'm going to speak to these people. You know, I was only, like I said, you know, sometimes I have to deal with various people for various things. And these particular people have a business and they do some things I need to do for them. But I just noticed that, you know, they had one of their children when I was talking to them around. And, you know, this guy, like I said, I looked at him and I could see that that he had some issues going on in his mind, you know. I'm not even sure if he has any friends. You know, I've seen this person before, and you know, they don't seem like a really social person, right? And so, you know, because I don't really like people, I can understand on some level, you know, the detachments. I can understand that. But when your detachments are coming from a place of, you know, you don't know who you are. See, I know who I am, and I detach from you people, you bad people, not the good people, not the people like me, but I detach from you bad people because I know who I am. And I can contrast who I am and my values to yours. And if they don't match up, then I know that you're not the right candidate to be my friend or be in my life. And I know that. But I don't think this guy knows who he is. And therefore, he's just a tumbleweed, so to speak, right? Blowing in the wind of life. And, you know, and that's really tragic. You know, a lot of these people who go to prison and do these heinous crimes in our society, a lot of them did not have any kind of nurturement as children. You know, they may have been left unattended for many, many hours as babies, right? Their parents may have been rough with them. Their parents may have not tried to support them or guide them. And that is why they are who they are as adults. So I do understand that many of you people in the world are fucked up because you had a fucked up life. Now, do you know what my life was all about? No, you don't. I don't speak to you about things that have gone on in my life because now in a successful place in my life, I can only look forward. But I've had many hard times in my life. Some maybe worse scenarios than you guys have experienced, but you don't know that because I'm strong enough. I was strong enough to make it through those experiences and grow from them and learn from them. So now I'm getting better and better every day. And I want to kind of teach you folks those techniques in life to try to overcome these obstacles, right? Because a lot of the obstacles are not external. They're not out here in the world. You can tackle these things. You can itemize them and then just swoop in on them and just take over on those things. The problem is what's going on in your actual minds. And that is the biggest fight you're going to have, is what's going on up here in your mind, right? I don't like people. I know I don't. I know why I don't like people, right? When I meet folks, I'm only looking for certain things in other people. Okay, I can do away with the rest of the bad apples in the bunch, right? I can do away with those, right? I only want healthy people around me. Maybe some of you folks should try to surround yourself with healthy people, right? And I'm telling you, you'll have a better peace of mind in your life because, you know, it's something that you need to really need to think about that. You know, some people are locked up right now and will not see the light of day, and they made a mistake. You know, they got themselves in a situation where they could not control their emotions, which is another one of those things that relates to those 3 D's, understanding of self. And they got themselves in a bunch in a situation that they couldn't get out of. So now, on the come up, they're trying to learn. And you know, a lot of these prison guys are really spiritual, and a lot of them have grabbed something. It took that rock bottom event to bring them to something better. So in some cases, many of you will have these travels in your life where you will have to literally absolutely hit the fucking floor before you can stand up and look and see that there's a better way of life and there's a better times for you ahead, right? You know, and I say I love bad behavior a lot. I always say that, you know, but do I really love it, right? Do I really love it? I love it in the context of trying to understand it. I love trying to pick this apart, but I don't love it for real. I really don't love bad behavior, but I do, if that makes any sense, because I'm human myself. And I really, part of the reason why we talk so much is because I just really see so much of the 3 D's. I see so much dysfunction, you know, so many folks are displaced and shit. Damn near all of you guys are disturbed. Damn near all of you. If you show me 10 people, 8 of them are disturbed. And that plays out in many ways, from its mildest point to the most severe, which is somebody actually harming you or taking something from you or doing something really terrible to you. But on the mildest levels, it's really about just basic social communication. And when you deal with other people, you may be callous, you may be very rude and disrespectful, and all of the low-level character traits that make people not like other people. You are those things. So I'm not going to take a whole lot of time on this lecture. I just had to have this real quick. You know, it's pretty early in the morning. It's fucking early as I don't know what. And I know a lot of you guys are probably about to get in the shower. I will hope some of you are going to get in the shower before you go to work. Because see all of that, even your hygiene, even how you see yourself relative to other people in the world, right? You know, it's wholly connected to the 3 D's. So I'll rehash those 3 D's just so you can grab those in your head and know that if you're any one of them or all of them, you need to start doing something right now, right? And if you're in a place where you find yourself depressed, because that could be another D, but we're not going to put that with that. But if you find yourself in a place of being depressed, then, you know, understanding yourself is going to help you, right? Really, really understanding and looking at the shit that comes with you and trying to get a shovel and get that shit out. That is what you need to do to be better, you know? So the 3 D's, disturbed. Being disturbed sets the course for everything. If you're not right up here, everything else you do is going to not be right. So we got to start from there. You're disturbed. You become displaced from being disturbed. And as a result of being displaced, your life, you live your lives on a dysfunctional level. The 3 D's, right? So I want you folks to have a good day. I'm about to get on and take care of some things. I need another cup of coffee because that, you know, one cup is not going to do for me. I, you know, some of you folks have like 5 cups. I'm not even going to say how many cups I have of coffee in a day, but I have a lot. I have a lot, dude. I have to go to the bathroom frequently. That's how much coffee I drink, right? But it does a lot for me. It picks me up and helps me get my day going. And I love coffee. I have acquired a taste for it. It's kind of like a wine thing. Some of you people don't like coffee. Some of you drink your tea in the morning. Whatever you do in the morning, right? I wish you the best in your endeavors today. If you're going to work, remember, listen to what I'm saying about these 3 D's and self-evaluate. When you're in that mirror today, combing your hair before you go to work, look in the mirror. Try to figure out all of the things that you don't think are good about you and work on those things and make an effort to be a better person. And then we can start from there because I'm tired of having to lecture you folks about this, right? The next time we talk, I may not be as nice as I am. Sometimes, you know, and like I said, I'll say this real quick. Sometimes, I'm very caring in a way that I'm trying to help you folks, right? And I'm only really all, honestly, I really don't like you people because I don't know you. But I'm trying to help you because to help you is to help me. If I help you, I can help someone in my family or I can help someone else. By helping you understand that you are creating a bad environment for other people. And if those people are stressed out, sometimes people commit suicide and they do all types of things based on what other people do to them and based on their strength levels or weaknesses that they can't handle. And then they resort to doing something crazy like harming themselves, right? Because they're disturbed already and then they're dealing with your dysfunction just compounds everything. So look in the mirror, folks, before you leave today to go to work and get in your car and get your coffee or whatever. Look in the mirror. Try to grab on to the negative things in yourself and then start systematically eliminating each of those bad things. And I promise you, your life will get better. Because I told you, the next time I experience one of these dysfunctional assholes, I'm going to let you guys hear about it. And I'm not going to be nice about it. I'm going to give you a piece of my mind, right? So you folks have a good day. We'll be talking soon. Take care.